Come now, have a seat. How are you feeling? I've been told it was no small feat to get you out of that Gundam safely.
So,
Yes?
Was that you? Were you the guy I fought with in that red mobile suit?
Do you have a problem sitting down to tea with a mortal enemy, Banagher Lynx? You have good reflexes, even if you're a bit reckless. However, that's a temperament not unbefitting a pilot.
This might sound rude, but may I ask, why do you wear that mask? Are you hiding a scar or something? I'd like to see your face. That is, if you have nothing to hide.
You dare!
It's fine, Lieutenant Angelo. Banagher is right. It's a matter of etiquette. I choose to wear this because it's my style, but it serves as a tool of propaganda. Most of the time, I forget I even have it on, until someone like you makes a point of mentioning it. My apologies. I've heard about how you met Princess Maneva. But as for how you came into possession of that mobile suit from the Vist Foundation, the Unicorn Gundam, there is much I have yet to understand. The truth is, the decision to turn over that machine to us had already been arranged. So what would make Cardius Vist suddenly choose you to be the bearer of Laplace's box?
I was asked the same thing by the two who escorted me here, and I already told them everything I know.
The prosperity of the Vist Foundation was due to its pact with the Federation government, an arrangement held in place by their secret possession of the box. But they chose to end all that and give it to us. It must have taken something significant to alter the plan, but even if something had gone wrong, why entrust the box to a stranger? What makes the most sense is that you have some relation to the Vist family. Well?
Is that a question I have to answer?
I said that's enough, Lieutenant.
You'd better learn respect, punk!
Of course you're not obligated to respond. We simply want information regarding Laplace's box. May I add that we're asking you respectfully because of your association with Princess Maneva. Please keep that in mind.
Princess Maneva? Audrey was very clear. She said Neo Zeon must not get the box. She said if they did, it would mean war.
Oh.
And after what happened to our colony, Industrial 7, anyone would feel the same way. She's a princess of Zeon, isn't she? If Audrey's against it, why are you trying to get the box? Why won't you listen to her?
Tell me, do you even believe in it? In the existence of Laplace's box? Do you believe in the existence of a box that no one has ever seen and whose contents are unknown, but nevertheless has the power to completely destroy the Federation government?
Well, I don't know. But I do believe that even the smallest things, like knowledge, have the power to change the future of the whole world in an instant.
Such as?
Well, like Zeon's first colony drop. Or hitting the Earth with an asteroid to start global cooling. Or centuries ago when they made nuclear weapons, or discovered Minovsky particles, or developed mobile suits. Even though it looks stable, the world changes little by little, right underneath our feet. If an idea comes along at the right time, it could have the power to change everything.
Absolutely right. And you seem to know your history well enough. Are you aware that space immigration was a policy of mass exile? Even though the autonomy of the side settlers is recognized, the central government retained the right to appoint its leaders. And since the space noids weren't allowed to vote, they may as well have had no suffrage whatsoever. Not all of Neo Zeon adheres to a single doctrine, but what we do have in common is the belief that this unjust system must evolve. In order to break from the oppressive rule of the Federation and realize the independence of the space noids, we've
had to... But no one should resort to terrorism! No matter how righteous you think you are, you can't just go around killing people! It's never right to take another life!
You little hypocrite! If it's never right to take another life, then you're as guilty as anyone for using the Gundam! You killed one of our best men out there. What do you have to say for that?
What?
It may have been a stray shot, but that doesn't change the fact that you shot him down!
I don't think Banagher even knows what you're talking about. He was probably acting purely on instinct. Ensign Sergei was just unlucky.
No. Did I kill him?
Call for Zinnerman. There is still so much you have yet to learn about who we really are. I want you to understand us. And it is my hope that given enough time, we will one day work together.
One more thing! Who are you? Are you Shar Aznable or aren't you?
As I am now, I consider myself nothing more than a vessel. A vessel for the hopes of those abandoned in space, and for the ideals of Zeon that will light all our paths to freedom. So if that's what the people desire, then Shar Aznable is who I will be. And that is the reason why I wear this mask.
Thank you.